A lot of people I love and really care about just can't understand why I believe some of the things I believe and why I don't believe in some of the things I don't believe in. Well, this is a true story about a boy named Jay, and I hope it can help you understand why. Yeah.
This is a strange idea.
Jay didn't know much, no, all that he knew was his mom loved God and great grandma did too. So loving God was something that you oughta just do. The Bible must be true if Gigi thought it was true. He saw graffiti on a church once, all he could do was think about Gigi and how sad it would've gotten it too. He started thinking about Christmas, cause all they would do was give gifts from a gift list and talk about food like they forgot about God. He died for all of us too. He thought he talked to mom and saw what she really knew.
Love you, mom.
She didn't even know the Son of God was a Jew. She didn't know the Bible much, yet she thought it was true. And sure, it was written by God, but she knew that men were corrupt, so she thought it probably was too. He thought, how can you tell the false parts from the true? This was the first of many problems that would bother him soon. He went from believing in Jesus to being a theist, to being a deist. Now he is an evil atheist, an evil atheist, an evil atheist. But he's not really as evil as people say he is. Went from believing in Jesus to being a theist, to being a deist. Now he is an evil atheist, an evil atheist, an evil atheist, but he's not really as evil as people say he is. He's in high school now, he still believes in a god, but there's so many gods and he thinks that it's odd. Egyptians way back when were believing in Ra, as strongly as Muslims now believe in Allah. But Mormons disagree with them, they think that they're wrong. They believe Joseph Smith even though he was a fraud. Scientologists too, it's like believing in God, and deceit go together like two peas in a pod. Catholics say the Pope is the vicar of Christ, Protestants say his claims the vicarship is a lie. Which tradition of the Christian religion is right? He doesn't get it no matter how long he sits and he tries. And then you got the Jews, which religion to choose? He couldn't choose. Then he was hit with the news, his Gigi died. He was sitting in pews, staring at a casket, wishing he knew what happens after death. He would sit there and stew while everybody says she's up there blowing kisses at you. He wished it were true, but deep within him he knew that was just wishful thinking. They were missing a two. Still in high school, Jay would often stay up at night listening to Art Bell late until light. One night, Art interviewed this atheist guy. It was this night that would mark a huge change in his life. He went from believing in Jesus to being a theist, to being a deist. Now he is an evil atheist, an evil atheist, an evil atheist. But he's not really as evil as people say he is. Went from believing in Jesus to being a theist, to being a deist. Now he is an evil atheist, an evil atheist, an evil atheist. But he's not really as evil as people say he is. He's never heard the word atheist. It came as a shock to hear this unapologetic atheist talk. Callers called in, but they couldn't take what he brought. Cold hard logic, like he was named Mr. Spock. Destroyed arguments against his with logic and reason. Said God was something that we just evolved to believe in, to deal with the fact one day we'd all be deceased. And when our family died, we still really wanted to see them. It all frightened Jay, he didn't wanna believe him. He felt like a life without God had no meaning, like beauty was an ugly deception, love an invention, an evolved monkey's invention. He couldn't believe he'd never see his grandma again. There was no heaven up there that grandma was in, and no hell down there where you were damned for your sins. It was Santa again, he couldn't stand it. And then his existential angst fell from him like snowflakes, slowly but surely, like the journey the snow takes. Started reading Nietzsche and Russell the old greats. Got the Carl Sagan, what he was saying was so great. Started reading Harris, then at Dawkins and Hitchens. All of them seem happy with their gods and religions, but everybody called them all evil atheists. Well, if that's evil, then I guess evil's what he is. Went from believing in Jesus to being a theist, to being a deist. Now he is an evil atheist, an evil atheist, an evil atheist. But he's not really as evil as people say he is. Went from believing in Jesus to being a theist, to being a deist. Now he is an evil atheist, an evil atheist, an evil atheist. But he's not really as evil as people say he is.
This is the only life where it's continually ending. It not only ends in death, but it ends in each moment, and things change. That makes each moment precious.